All these people that died and they died and they were Christians, and now their relatives are fighting for their money because of all the money that they left in the bank. And the Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 16 that when the rich man died, they bury him, they put him in a casket, something like that, and they bury him. And from hell, he was watching his relatives fighting for his money. I can just imagine the relatives of this rich man fighting over this man's money, praying for this. If they were Catholic, they would probably say, hey, blood, Mary, please put this man out of purgatory, you know, trying to intercede for the dead, because Catholics believe that you go to purgatory and you go to other places. There's only two places, heaven or hell. Yeah. And this man, when he was in hell, he was interceding for the ones up there and say, hey, I have five brothers who are thieves, who are fornicators, yes, who are sinners. Can you send Lazarus? Yes. Can you send somebody so they're not end up in this place? Yeah. But the only one that can intercede for you is the Lord Jesus Christ. There's only one mediator between man and God, and that is Jesus Christ.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
When they get to hell, they're trying to be mediators, and they're trying to beg, hey, I have family that's still wicked and demonic. Can you send somebody? They have Pastor Danny Scott. They have Sister Nash that can, if they don't hear them, they're not going to hear anybody else.
Yeah.
Praise God. The Bible is clear that the rich man was watching his family fight over his money. And that's why I have a suggestion for all of you brothers and sisters that are watching and they're in this room. If you have money in the bank, spend all your money now. Don't wait until you die and you're in a casket and your relatives are fighting over your money. Your cat, your dog, your bird, everybody's gonna want a piece of you. If you have money, your more relatives that you never knew you had, they're gonna come and say, hey, that was my cousin, hey, that was my uncle, I want a piece of that money. No, spend your money today. We gotta preach the gospel. Use the money to preach the gospel.
Yes.
We gotta deliver turkeys. There's people with no water and electricity right here in McDowell County. Today, when you can, go and buy a gift for somebody and enjoy the smile that you're gonna put on somebody's face. Not when they're dead.
That's right.
You got all these people fighting for the money. And this reminds me of a lady who says his 80th ungodly husband was dying, and she was Christian, and she said to him, and he said to her, I want you to bury me with all my money. When I die, I want you to put all my money in the casket. And she said okay, I will do that. I will put all your money in the casket. And at the end, when they were getting ready to put this casket in the ground, she was still thinking, how I'm going to put all the money in the casket, and I have to keep my word. That's right. She got a check, and she write a check, and he said, here's your money.
I love it.
She kept her word,
yeah,
like a good Christian, yeah, didn't lie. How is this man who's going to cast that check in the afterlife?
Yeah.
It's the Lord. That's why you gotta spend all your money in the Christianity. Buy Bibles. Do something to preach the gospel.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Don't store treasures here on the air when people is gonna fight when you die. Store treasures up in heaven. Praise God. But people do not know what death means, and they play with the dead. They make fun of the dead, and God cannot be mocked.
Amen.
In Mexico, we use every year, November 1st and 2nd, is 2 days, the Mexicans celebrate the dead. And I remember when I was little, my grandmother, she lost a boy. And every November 1st and 2nd, she would put an altar with his picture. There's always a cross next to the dead. I don't know why. Because Jesus is not on that cross. And she put the best, all the foods that he liked, and she put some tequila and beer, because they were waiting for the dead to get out of their graves on November 1st and 2nd and come out and eat all this food. And nobody else was allowed to touch that food. We were starving, but the dead was going to come and eat this food. But guess who ate that food at night? Huh? Yes. And they were thinking that the dead was eating this food.
Yeah.
And they go to the graveyards and they do the same thing. They sit next to the graveyard and they serve some tacos or turkey or whatever. And they pour a glass of tequila for them and a glass of tequila for the ones that are dead. And they bring mariachis and they have a celebration because they think the dead is going to come out of the graves on November 1st and 2nd. But the Bible says there is a big gap between the rich man and the beggar, and nobody can go there and nobody can go this way.
Amen.
Ignorance. They don't know, they don't prepare themselves. In Europe, they're more sophisticated, you know? Environmental friendly. If you die over there, they freeze your body, they dry your body, and they crush your body, then you became dust and ashes, and after 12 months, you're a good fertilizer. If you have tomatoes, and you can throw your husband or your wife on the tomatoes or whatever you want, and you're gonna have good tomatoes. But that's what these fools, that's what society, that's what people who do not know the Bible do. They spend all this money, all this time, and in things and things of the flesh to satisfy the flesh. You know? The Egyptians, they will bury the pharaohs with gold, with silver, with guns, even the slaves. They even throw the slaves on the graves because they say they're going to need all this after in the afterlife. The Bible said, naked you came into this world, naked you're going to go out. If they throw you slaves, if they can throw everything, and they go ahead, and they put flags around the caskets, and they put all kinds of things, and they throw money, and they throw flowers, and they put everything on these caskets. But it's not going to do you any good.
That's right.
The only thing that's going to do you good is if you have the Lord Jesus Christ. Wow. Is the only thing that you can take with you.
Glory to God.
Amen. That's right. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. People run from God their entire lives. They don't want to know nothing about God. They don't care about God. And they think that when they die, they're not going to know nothing about God. And they're wrong, because God is omnipresent. He's everywhere.
Yeah.
He's even in hell. Satan is not the king of hell.
Right.
Book of Psalms 139:7-8 says this: where can I go from your spirit? Oh, where can I flee from your presence? If I ascended into heaven, God is there. You are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there. They go on trying to hide from God and run away from God, but even in hell, he's going to be watching you, going through the torments of hell. God cannot be mocked. We have read the scripture, 1 Corinthians 15:15. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Paul knew this subject, this topic, very well. And he was a man who was ready to die, and he will dare the dead to come and take him away. He'll say, oh, dead, where is thy sting? Where are you? Oh, grave, where is thy victory? He was calling the dead. He said, where are you, dead? And in the same chapter, the Apostle Paul said, the last enemy that Jesus Christ is going to defeat is dead.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
The whole chapter 1 Corinthians Verse 15 talks about the dead. That's why I love victory in Jesus, because he said that the Lord Jesus Christ has gone up in heaven. How did that go? To make a mansion for us, to prepare a mansion for us. He said, to me, live is Christ, and to die is gain. He was a winner either way.
Yeah.
He was not afraid of the dead, and that's how the true Christian has to be, not afraid to be inside of this casket. Because once you're in this casket, you're no longer dead. All there is dead is just flesh, because your spirit is already with the Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
Why do we have to walk around afraid of being dead? Absent of the body is present with the Lord. But why did he say flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of heaven? Because the human body, as long as your spirit is inside this body, the human body is good. Once your spirit leaves this body, once the spirit leaves your body, this human body is good for nothing. Nothing. doctors, science, they can have all kinds of PhDs, diplomas, they cannot reproduce another human body. The human body is a great machine. As long as the Spirit of God is inside of you, the Spirit of God, God is so merciful even with the sinners that He allows them, allow their bodies to move and to react like the one, like our bodies that we have the Holy Ghost. Even God put us, put inside of us a software that, I don't know, I'm going to explain it this way. When the army goes and fights battles in Iraq and Afghanistan, and they're getting ready to go back home, they're getting ready to leave, they'll destroy everything they cannot bring with them. They'll destroy generators, they'll destroy bases, everything. They don't want to leave nothing for the enemy. It is the same way with us. Once the spirit is no longer in your body, this body is gonna corrupt. It's gonna destroy itself. And I was looking for the nutritional value of the human flesh, not because I want to eat you guys, but I wanted to know if the flesh, if the human flesh was good for something, you know? But it's good for nothing. That's what the Bible said. Those who are after the flesh, the flesh is going to lead you nowhere. Nowhere. I did not find the nutritional value of the human body. But in the other hand, the Bible says, Jesus Christ says, I am the bread of life. Eat of my flesh. Drink of my blood. And the nutritional value of the flesh, of Jesus Christ's flesh, is eternal life. Hallelujah. No calories, no cholesterol, no potassium, no sodium. Eternal life. That is the nutritional value of the flesh that we eat every time we take communion.